presentation.
When I find myself in times of trouble, Mother Mary comes to me, speaking words of wisdom, let it be. And in my hour of darkness, she is standing right in front of me, speaking words of wisdom, let it be, let it be, let it be, let it be, let it be. Whisper words of wisdom, let it be.
When the broken-hearted people
drums, and there's a one lime goes into Hale and Pacey's box. That's the Royal Box.
That's right, yeah.
And relies on it.
We've got players.
Let's go.
All right, Rick.
Roll on the drum. Okay. Lime in the ball box now. So roll on the drum.
Expecting Her Majesty, wasn't he? I'm afraid Her Majesty is a bit tied up.
And locked in a broom cupboard.
As you may or may not know, we are...
The management.
We manage things. And in our time, we manage many things. We've held dances. We've held discos. Once we even held a Lord Mayor's ball.
Till he came round to our way of thinking.
Oh, dear, Ron, they're laughing.
Oh, dearie, dearie me.
Don't laugh at Ron. Laughing at Ron is bad.
Bad Ron.
So don't laugh no more.
More Ron.
We'd like to welcome you to this.
The London Palladium, Ron.
This is our little place and you're welcome.
Yeah, you're welcome to it.
Me and Ron don't come from round here. We come from...
Wormwood Scruffs.
The East End.
Oh, yeah. The East End, right, yeah.
And like all EastEnders, we're warm. Friendly.
And psychopathic.
We like EastEnders.
Yeah, especially Lofty. Hey, Shell, when I hold you up to my ear, I can hear the sound of the sea.
You may not know this, but me and Ron have been in the entertainment game for some time now. Nowadays, entertainment's big business. Ron here knows all about big business.
Since I've been on a high-fibre diet.
I can wait.
I couldn't, it was terrible.
You may not be aware of this, but Ron here is one of the country's outstanding stand-up chameleons. And here to tell you a very funny joke is Ron.
There was this geezer, right? And he had two broken legs.
Now that's what I call funny. But not only joking, Ron also's a bit of a crooner.
Croon.
In our time, we've both had a large number of
hits.
First cut is the deepest.
Stranglers in the night.
My particular favourite, if you were the only girl in the world...
I'd make a fortune as your pimp.
It's difficult to laugh without a tongue.
Especially where I'm gonna put it.
Not only crooning, Ron's a bit of a poet. And here with his latest poem is Ron.
Mary had a little lamb. Its fleece was very red. The reason for it was, you see, it had a pickaxe for its head.
I don't like clapping.
I don't like Brighton.
You're not just here to enjoy yourselves tonight, you're here for charity. Me and Ron like charity. We think that those in need should be given.
And those who don't give should be need.
So to remind you lot of your responsibility, I've got a little ditty.
Have you?
It's a poem what me and Ron have writ. It goes something like this. People just like you and
me
give their cash to charity. So have your fun and have your
frolics,
but pay the money.
Or I'll have your
guts forgotten. Right, we got to go now, so there's only one more thing to do.
To do, Ron.
Ron. To do, Ron.
Ron. Right.
And that's to hand that over to one of the stars of the show, so...
Bye-bye.
was Hale and Pace. Now, wasn't that fucking awful? Now you know why the theatres are empty every night. We got some shit in here tonight, I know. Frankie Howard, he used to comedy what piles are to Lester Piggott. Pat Mooney, the little fat ass one. Make a good burglar in his heart, there'll be footprints out. Jim Bowie. He's about as funny as Rock Hudson giving fucking blood, that fella. Jim Davis and his mother-in-law's in here tonight somewhere. I spotted her early on. Got a face like a fucking bulldog chewing a wasp. Roger De Gorsi. Fucking hell, is he still going? Last time he appeared at the Palladium, Frankie Howard was stopping the bill. Mike Reed, well, he's been a friend of mine for many years, as you know. And queers need friends. I'll tell you a joke before I go, because I'm on later on. English fella knocking this Irish woman off. She says, you haven't got AIDS, have you? He says, no. She says, thank fuck for that. She says, I don't want that again. I'll see you later on in the show.
Shines. You can study Shakespeare and be quite elite. Or you can be the critics but be off on your feet. Or slip on a banana, blame and stardom too sweet. Make a laugh, make a laugh, make a laugh. Make him laugh. Make him laugh. Don't you know, everyone wants to laugh. My dad said be an actor, my son. But they are coming from what I'll be standing in line. Out of all hunting from money shines. Or you can study Shakespeare and be quite elite. Or you can charm the critics, but you won't get to eat. So step on a banana skin and black on your feet. Make them laugh, make them laugh.
Oh, no, they're not here. Right, good evening. Welcome to the show. Guess what? I've left my suit at home. Had to borrow this off Bernard Manning. We were all just saying there early on, you know, what jokes are we going to do tonight? How can we set the tone? He said, leave it to me. So we're all going home now. Can I introduce you to someone? Look at that. A stagehand.
It's up. It's better. Now, this is being televised, actually, not live at the moment.
Don't worry, come in, walk in late, I'll come round your house and walk round while you're performing. Great stuff. Great. Have you come far? Quite a way. What, whereabouts, mate? Sorry?
Ramsgate.
Terrific place. My, funny, Ramsgate, my brother's working in Ramsgate tonight. About 9 o'clock he starts. Yeah. He's a burglar. Look at the front row. Oh, my Christ, there's a miserable gits here. Bernard was right, eh? Hello. Hello, mate. Chloroform drinkers on the front row. That time, mate, you've been sick all down your shirt. Is that what we... Dark glasses. Hello, mate. What, are you a superstar or a spot welder? They do luck the business.
we all know why we're here tonight, so we won't dwell on it. I mean, whatever we do tonight, we're going to have a laugh, and it won't change what has happened. We obviously know that. But we'll try and have a laugh and try and raise a few quid. Thank you all for coming. There's lots of comedians on here and some singers and everything, and we've got loads and loads of bands, and it has been bloody bedlam. There was about 500 people here today, all rehearsing. Yeah, honestly. I mean, I was the only one I didn't know. I mean, there's millions of stars here. And we had one rehearsal, which lasted about 5 hours. Like, didn't see that in the sun, did you? And, yes, and we haven't had a dress rehearsal or anything, so it's sort of thrown together a little bit. And if there's anyone going to be offended by any bad language or jokes like that, I think you ought to piss off now. I mean, let's be fair. Anyway, right. A couple of gentlemen now have come here to entertain you. They are rather special. They had us in hysterics today at our one rehearsal. Would you please welcome and give them a London Palladium welcome, eh? Especially for tonight. Kit and the Widow. Give them a round of applause. Come on now.
Little white-headed lady, clinically hardly alive, lived all alone at Clarence House at the age of 85. She received a letter one morning, which with fumbling hands she read. With her dim and rheumy eye, she scanned it. This is what it said. Mr. Norman Fowler says, presenting his respects, that as from now you must avoid violent anal sex. Carry some condoms just in case, and make sure your lubricant's water-based. Mr. Norman Fowler says, drop it, pop it, or pop your clogs and cop it. Mr. Norman Fowler says, stop it. The dear little white-headed lady, saucer-eyed with horror, festooned her hall with Durex to ward off this Gomorrah. This all in spite of the fact that she had given up carnal trafficking long ago, way back in the mists of time, about the year of mafficking. Mr. Norman Fowler says now's not the time to start an intimate relationship with a Central African tart. Though it might cause acute distress, put it about a little less. Mr. Norman Fowler says, drop it, pop it, or pop your clogs and cop it. Mr. Norman Fowler says, stop it. The frail little white-headed pussy, flushed hot and cold in shame. Her fluids had long been dormant, her morals beyond all blame. But recalling a corgi that nibbled at her ear in 34, she rattled a bedpan in her guilt and read a little more. Mr. Norman Fowler says, where'er it might impinge, try not to lick any open wounds and use a clean syringe. The daffy old duck could take no more. She trundled her bath chair through that door. 3 weeks and Mr. Fowler had a postcard by return, headed to whom it may concern. Having heard from that dear Mr. Fowler what I've missed over 65 years, I'm now in a cocaine parlor in the Casbah in Old Tangiers with a tribe of bisexual Maasai who are big and butch and black. And thanks to Mr. Fowler, I'm never coming back.
Ladies and gentlemen, from London, Mr. Mike Reed. made a mess of that, haven't I? All right, darlings, how are you? Answer me, ain't hard. I'm not the Pope. Oh, a lovely dressing room I got out there, super. On the door, there's a notice that says, beware of homosexuals. There was another notice on the mirror that said, beware of homosexuals. There was a message on the floor. I bent down to look at it. He said, you've been warned twice. I was coming in here at night, a big Doberman dog jumped on my leg and it was going, wee. I said, get off. It went, rrr. I said, well, hurry up then. Oh, I've had a week of it. I'm laying in bed with the old woman last night. 3 o'clock in the morning, she sat bolt upright and said, quick, my husband's coming. And like a bloody idiot, I jumped out the window. This morning, I took my car into a Jewish garage and said, Simonise it. They cut 2 inches off the exhaust pipe. I've come out the house tonight. You know what it's like out there, a bit raining and that. I've got about 2 mile down the road. This copper stepped out in the middle of the road. He put his hand up to stop me, but he weren't strong enough, so I pulled him aside. Walked over to me, you know, typical copper. Good evening, squadron leader. Having trouble taking off, are we, sir? I said, what do you want? He said, you know, you were doing 60 miles an hour. I said, couldn't you make it 90, mate? I'm trying to settle the car. Oh, he said, I see. You're a silly boy, aren't you? I said, I ain't standing out there in a bleeding rain, am I? Oh. He said, I'm going to give you a ticket. I said, what's that, boy? Some sort of raffle. He said, if you like Winkle, 3 of those and you can get yourself a bike. I don't know. He said, listen. He said, this is your car. I said, that belongs to my mate, Tommy Hall. He said, what sort of a car is it? I said, the Vauxhall. He said, where you been to? I said, Mildenhall. He said, where you going? I said, Southall. He said, what you got in the boot? I said, find out for yourself. I said, I've always wanted to be a copper. He said, couldn't you get in? I said, no. He said, why not? Didn't you pass the medical? I said, 100% fit, son, 100% fit. He said, what about the IQ test? I said, 97.5. He said, really? Why don't you think you never got in then? I said, well, probably because my mum and dad were married. I don't know. Cheesed up, man. Where was the last one? Belfast. You all know Belfast? Lovely town, that. Twin town with Beirut, Belfast. Inflation remains constant over there. The prices are still the same, but the shops are coming down, you know. Week before that was in Bradford. Anybody here from Bradford? They dropped an atom bomb on Bradford, it done 15 quid's worth of damage. Listen to this. Basically, I'm talking to the fellas. Fellas, I don't know how you feel, but after being away from home, after a couple of days, I always start feeling a bit... I found this little Jewish pub in Bradford called the Kosher Horses. Well, I'm in there having a drink. Listen, for Christ's sake, listen. In the corner is a bit of class. Now, when I say class, I mean class. I walked over and, hello, darling. She went, hi there. Oh, I said, you're American. She said, I sure am. You're British. I said, yeah, I'm British, darling. She said, as a matter of fact, my friends and myself were just discussing about the greatest lovers in the world. And we think that the British man is the third greatest lover. Oh, I said, that's nice to be in a frame, isn't it? Lovely, yeah, it's delightful, yeah. Who do you find the best lovers? We think the greatest lovers are cowboys and Jews. And by the way, what's your name? I said, I belong Goldberg. Deep South Alabama, USA, this big black fella's got a frog in his hand. And he said, frog, you know what I'm gonna do with you? I'm gonna pull one of your legs off. And then I'm gonna pull another one of your legs off. All of a sudden, this big shadow overcome, and he looked round, there's this massive redneck sheriff standing there. He said, boy, everything due to that frog, I'm gonna do to you. He said, frog, this time your lucky day, I'm gonna kiss your ass. Been a long time. Yeah, I've got a lot of stars here tonight, a lot of personalities. She was supposed to be here, Joan Collins, with her new boyfriend, Bungalow Bill. I suppose she's eels over it in love with him. Hey, I don't know, all these geese are taking young wives, Bruce Forsyth, young wife, and all, you know, Des O'Connor, young wife. I would not have bleak and do with one, me. I've got one in bed, it'd be like playing snooker with a bit of rope. I'll stick with my old woman, she's out there somewhere tonight. I brought her along tonight, it saves kissing her goodbye, you know. Will you, I haven't got time for all that. Listen, I went to the doctor's last week. He said, I ain't seen you for a long time. I said, no, you're pillock, I've been ill. He said, what's the problem? Listen! He said, what's the problem, Mike? I said, oh, me and the old woman, you know, look, been married 26 years now. The old sex life's a bit dodgy, you know what I mean? Tried everything. We tried a wife swapping party last week. I did quite well. We got a set of socket spanners for her, but I took her to a brothel 2 months ago. They charged me corkage, you know, and I know again, when I got married, I mean, you're not exactly bursting with O-levels at 17 years old. We drove over to Paris, see, took the mother-in-law with us. What a miserable old cow she is, right? Moaned all the way, right? Still moaning when we took her off the roof rack. But, right, not really... Listen. We found this little honeymoon hotel. This little honeymoon hotel. I've gone upstairs with the bedroom with the wife. I locked the bedroom door, took my trousers off, threw them on the bed. I said to my missus, put the trousers on. She said, what? I said, put the trousers on. I said, put the bloody trousers on, will you? She went, all right, Trappy, all right. She got me strides on. I said, listen, because I'm only going to tell you this once. That is the first and the last time you wear the trousers in this house. She said, please yourself. She took my trousers off and took her knickers off and threw them at me. She said, put them on. I should never bleed and get into them. She said, no, until you change your attitude, cocky, you won't.
Yeah, I know.
Migraine. First time I met her mum and dad, and they were nice people at that stage, and they're going, we've been caught in about 2 weeks, we've gone back to her house, and I'm outside the back door trying to do the business, right? She went, not here. I said, she went, not here. So look, Mum and Dad come round my lunch Sunday. They go to church every Sunday at 2 o'clock. Said, whatever you do, we can spend the afternoon upstairs. But before you come round, go down the chemist and get a... I said, all right. I got round there Sunday, I met her Mum and Dad. Nice people, we had a bleeding nice time. Lo and behold, she was right 2 o'clock. The old man got up, he said, Son, well, it's nice to meet you. I hope you enjoyed your lunch. Me and Mum are going to church now. I said, can I come with you? He said, what? I said, can I come with you? He said, do you want to go to church, boy? I said, I'd love to. He said, bloody marvellous, son. That's super. Me and Mum will get her out. We'll meet you in the hallway. They went out. She said to me, what are you bloody all doing? How long have you been religious? I said, how long's your old man been a chemist? But now, my mother-in-law, 26 years later, she is massive. 33 stone she weighs. No matter where you're sitting in the room, she's sitting next to you. And she wears them big elastic knickers. We were going through the woods the other day, the elastic in a knicker broke. Broke down 4 trees. She hung her knickers on the line to dry and a family of gypsies moved in. Witherdals. And the size of her bum. She's taller sitting down than she is standing up. And I got the father-in-law. Oh, that is a silly old sod, he is. Thick as 2 planks. He's a long-distance lorry driver on the Isle of Wight. Oh. One of the geezer turned up at the door the other day. He said to my father-in-law, I'm from the double glazing people, mate. You've had it 7 months now. You ain't paid a penny piece. My father-in-law said, you told me it'd pay for itself within a year. I went round his house the other day. I said, God help us, Dad, your ceilings are high, aren't they? He said, yeah, your mother wanted 2 rooms knocked into one. Last time I was at the West End of London, I found a little restaurant round the corner. There was no one in the place, just the fella behind the counter. I said, evening. He said, yes, sir, can I help you? Yeah, I said, all right, give us a brandy, mate. He said, certainly, sir. I said, how much is that? He said, a penny. A penny? Make it a large one. I said, don't want to do a nice, thick, juicy T-bone steak with French fried potatoes, French fried onions, and an egg sunny side up, do you? He said, certainly, sir, when it comes to money. I said, how much? He said, 4 pence. I said, 4 pence? Who owns this place? He said, the geezer named Wilwright. I said, where's he then? He said, upstairs with my missus. I said, what's he doing upstairs with your missus? He said, same as I'm doing down here with his business. Any Irish in tonight? Question too difficult. Irish fella said to his mate, he said, Mick, you're losing your hair. Why did you have a transplant? He said, I look worse with a kidney on my head. Irish fella went to the doctor. The doctor said, son, you'll have to be circumcised. Oh, he said, that's no skin off my nose. Do you hear about the Irish fella thought he was the greatest lover in the world till he found out his wife had asthma? House in Ireland, flames leaping up in a bloody air, and a woman appeared at the window with a baby, and the crowd went, throw the baby down. She said, I came to be killed, to be killed. Don't be a pilchard, throw the baby down. She said, I came to be killed, to be killed. Out the crowd he stepped, Mrs. I'm the Irish international goalkeeper, I've never dropped a ball in my life. Throw the baby down. With that, she threw the baby out the window. As the baby was coming down, there was a gust of wind, and it took the baby to one side. The goalie leapt in the air and snatched the baby from death. The crowd went raving mad. Hooray! Hooray! He bounced the baby twice and... All right, darlings, God bless you. Thanks very much, indeed.
Oh, blimey, eh? Oh, Mike, there's a man. We're just saying, he has entertained generations of audiences, that bloke. And the same to you, you filthy swine. Yeah, Mike Reed. Give him another round of applause, boys and girls, ladies and gentlemen. Right. I'm going to put subtitles on. Are you enjoying it? Now, first, have you all bought a programme? We'll tear it up because the running order's changed completely. All right, I'm going to introduce you to a gentleman now. Did you see Opportunity Knox last night? Well, he weren't on that. He won another thing called New Faces, which I did with a few other people that's on the bill tonight. 3 years ago. 1976. And he won the gala final about 6 months ago up in Birmingham. Anyone from Birmingham? Well, bloody good. I love Birmingham. They're mock curries. They're great, and they wear. You've got two toilet rolls in the fridge for the morning, you know. You know you've had one, you're dehydrated, you sit on the toilet and your arse goes down for a drink, doesn't it? Hey, that's what... Anyone in from Scotland?
Yes!
Great, okay, then you're going to enjoy this fella. He's from Scotland. He won New Faces, and rightly so. I voted for him to win, and because I think he's a terrific fella. A very funny man. Will you welcome Dougie Small?
Yes! Right! Send him on it! Think I'll take a walk in the park. Hey. Hello. Come on. Thank you. A Japanese joke. Oh, I think that's what I got going on. Oh, I think that's what I got going on. We've heard it. And it's not on the television where you find characters. I mean, they're everywhere. I was shopping in London last week, and I found a pound coin on the pavement, and I picked it up, and I put it in my pocket, and you would say to yourself, if I found a pound coin, I'd keep it as well. Of course you would, but we've all got different ways of picking money up, and I proved it. Just for a laugh, I got 3 one-pound coins, and I put one on the pavement, and the first fella that walked along was a weightlifter. This is a weightlifter picking the pound up. Pound! Pound! you. The second fella was brilliant. He was one of those rockers. Have you seen the rockers with the motorbikes? Picks it up like this. Brilliant. The last fella was brilliant. The last fella was Wayne Sleep, the ballet dancer. He picks it up like this. Things fall and roll off the stage of mine. Hey, you've been a fantastic crowd. I've got to fly now, because thank you. Go.
Ladies and gentlemen, an unknown entertainer with an unknown animal.
Thank you very much. An unknown entertainer. I like that. Well, good evening. We're going to do some, for the benefit of the people that haven't seen me work before, especially this home of variety here, we're going to do, a lot of people haven't seen me work, so I'll do a little bit of explaining. A lot of people don't realise that when I do this act with the bear, that it is in fact my voice coming from the dummy. Now, yeah, right, so tonight, just to prove that it's my voice coming from the bear, I'm going to let my lips move just a little bit. There. Hello?
Hello.
You in?
Where are we?
Palladium.
Oh, good. What are you doing?
I can't see.
Well, you're missed. You're still missed.
Thank you.
Dig in it.
All right, listen, coming out you come. Let's, out you come, they'll give you a lovely round of applause. Ah, thank you. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, and those of you that followed you in. Now, nice to be here at the Palladian. Nice to be out of the docks. Thank you. Storm's getting nearer. Nice to get out of the docks. You see, I never know where I'm going to be when I come out of the docks. You see, last night I was in Bristol, come out the docks, torn apart, went back in the docks. Next thing I know, I come out the docks. It's the Palladium. Now, that don't mean a lot to you, but I just ain't in thid. Sympathy I don't want, thood. Thood, I don't get a lot of thood. Thast thood I get these days. Thast thood, according to the geezer next to me, is anything that goes through the top of the lid quickly. At the moment, Aldran. I've had five boxes of Aldran through the tot of the lid this week.
And I'd now got a Dunlop around a burnt toast. Now, don't take a lot of imagination, ladies and gentlemen, to realise that there ain't a lot of run in this docks. So you either got to tread in it or eat it. I've just consumed my fifth box of Aldran, and I'm hungry. What are you doing about it?
Cooking.
Cooking? Mm. What are you cooking?
I was quite happy where I was.
What are you cooking?
It's a gargacue.
What?
Gargacue.
Well, dardacue, really. I'm just making it easier for you. All right, fine. Yes, that's it. What have you got on the barbecue?
None of my feet.
No, listen, what?
Did you know that Ken Dodd's dad's dog's dead? Did you know that you death? Did you know that Ken Dodd's dad's dog's dead died of dysentery in Doncaster?
Who told you?
Gerald Sinstead said it at Stansted Airport.
Recognise him?
Yes, wearing a short sleeve silk shirt, he bought in a short sleeve silk shirt sale. What are you trying to do? Make you sweat?
Right, fine. Carry on. Okay. What are you cooking on the barbecue?
Right. Tonight's recipe is duck. Duck, ladies, those of you that haven't had a duck for a long time, I shall explain, well, it is a delicacy, a duck. Now, this is barbecue duck a la Palladian. First of all, nick a duck. Did you know Tesco's are merged with NFI?
Really?
Bought a chicken yesterday, their legs fell off.
All right, fine.
Now, this is duck. I went to an unusual pets competition yesterday.
Did you?
Yes, Irishman with a tin of salmon on it. Now, this now this is duck. Duck a la Palladian. Now, ladies, first of all, nick a duck. Then, when you get the duck, you take its clothes off. Well, you don't. You cluck it, really, but he can't say that. Now, you cluck the duck. If he gets it wrong, it's going to kill this show. Cluck the duck. Now, I plucked the duck. I got one already plucked in the docks. Yep, got it in the docks.
Good.
The next thing, ladies, is to insert the left arm.
Oi.
And search for the giblets. Now, these are in a plastic container somewhere near the neck of the duck. No use to man or beast unless you want to kill next door's cat. Now, the next bit is the bit I personally enjoy, ladies, is stuffing the duck. Quite easy to do.
Really?
Mm. Thank you.
What are you stuffing it with?
Does it look like Paxo?
No, I'm just asking a question.
How much have you got in it? About a foot.
Don't be silly. Listen, what's a... That's a ridiculous statement.
I haven't got it all in. All right, fine. Yes, I know that.
Let's just have the recipe.
All right, this is a recipe, ladies. First of all, get the duck's legs akimbo. Get your stuffing in your hand. Take a healthy run at it. And then the...
All right, hey, hey. No. Hey, hey.
Right. Just leave it out. It ain't in. All right, listen. Go on.
Let's have the recipe.
Right, this is a recipe, ladies. First of all, insert. Insert. A pineapple. Followed. By a pomegranate, followed by a cucumber.
Thank you very much.
It ain't a cucumber that the duck don't know that. All right, fine.
Should taste very nice.
I ain't killed it yet. All right, fine. Come on. Out.
Sit. Just sit on the edge of the box.
Oh, jeez. Right.
Now, I've found something out about you, so that they don't bounce.
Yes, all right, listen, what?
Hmm? You've been working without me. Get away. Wish I could. Nothing would give me greater pleasure than to see you drive home to Bushy on your own tonight. You've been working without me. You've been doing things behind my back. Kinky, innit? I'm not interested in that. The duck likes it. I don't care what the duck likes. Spread your tiny wings and whack, whack, whack. All right, fine. Anyone for a Donald? All right. That's enough. We're not interested in ducks or your sexual deviations with ducks. Ducks are out. We are not into ducks, nor am I. Really? Swan hunting. Pardon? Swan hunting. It's all right until you get out of step. Now look, this son. You've been working without me. I switched the television on the other night, got a terrible shock. Wogan wasn't on. Well, you were in that sexy series. What's it called? Dysentery. Dynasty. Now I call it dysentery because it's a load of be that as it may. You were in it. In bed with Joan Collins. I was shocked, so was she. Yes. Mind you, the duck was dead. Never mind. Right. Say goodnight to everybody. Ladies and gentlemen, another good show. Good night. God bless you. Take care. Good night. In this the box. Good night.
This is for all of you out there that don't want to clap your hands. We can get you to kind of snap your fingers, kind of sing along with us on this one. It simply says, when the night has come and the land is dark,
sing it, Eddie.
And the moon is the only light we see. No, I won't be afraid, no, I won't be afraid. Just as long as you stand by me. Can you sing it with us? So darling,
darling, stand by me. Crumble and fall, and the mountain should tumble to the sea.
Well, say it, girl.
I won't cry,
no, no.
I won't cry, no. I won't shed a tear, just as long as you
stand up.
Stand by.
Lovely, Jim. Lovely. Is there anybody in from Cornwall?
How the hell am I going to get home? I tell you what, I'm not coming up here again. I come to London today and I was waiting on the bus stop and there's thousands waiting for the bus. And I went upstairs and there was one empty seat and I sit down and the most horrible woman that I ever seen come and sit right beside me. She was horrible. Her ass was that wide, she was hellish. And she stunk of Swarfiga. I think she must have been the mechanic. But she was nothing to do with me. I wasn't even talking to her. And there are thousands on the bus. I thought, I hope they don't think that's my wife. And then she started talking to me. She said, are you local? Well, I said, I am when I'm home. She said, well, where do you live? I said, I live down in Cornwall. She said, have you lived in Cornwall all your life? Well, hell, I said, not yet. Then she said, do you think anybody would notice if I was going to break wind? Well, why involve me? It's nothing to do with me, is it? I said, it's your house, do whatever you like. She said, I'm going to, and she was going to, I could tell by her eyes she was. I said, hold your ass steady. If you do, all these people is going to think I done that. I'll tell you what I'll do, I'll cough. And you leave her go when I'm coughing. She said, how long can you cough for? Hell. I said, have you got to do it? Well, she said, I got to now. She said, he's already in the departure lounge. Yeah. Look, I said, hang on for a minute. And when the driver changed gear, leave her go when he changed gear. And nobody will ever know you done it. I'll help you. When he put his clutch in, I shall say, Habba. And when I say, Habba, you leave her go. But we want a short, sharp blast. Right, I said, hold your ass steady, mind, any time now. Are you ready to go? Hold your ass now, any time. Exactly as he changed gear. Habba. My Christ, hell. How she never blowed her hintrals right out, I'm fucking. And I've never heard a quieter gear change. Even the driver looked proud of what he'd done. Well, no, everybody stopped talking. But you couldn't talk, you couldn't draw a breath. Stinking. And the people up the front had their windows down, head out the window. Hellish, stinking. I thought, I'll just say something to the conductor to start people talking. Perhaps he won't smell so bad if they're talking. I said, excuse me. I said, sorry to bother you, but I said, have you got a timetable I could have? But he said, I haven't got a timetable, but he said, I'll open the window and try to grab a handful of leaves for you. I was lucky to get here at night. Lucky I was, because my mate in Cornwall, Denzel Penberthy, he's had trouble this morning. His dog have swallowed a condom. And he rung the vet. He said, can you come as soon as you can? We're in trouble. My dog have swallowed a condom. He said, don't let the dog move. Keep the dog still. I'll get there as soon as I can. After about 5 minutes, Denzel rung the vet again. He said, you know that dog that swallowed the condom? Yes, he said, don't bother to come now. He said, we found another one in the drawer. Now, I mustn't stay too long because I got another gig end of the summer. But Jim said, if you're coming up, could you sing one of those lovely West Country folk songs? Because, see, I've got a new girlfriend now. She's a lovely girl, but she got terrible great zits. But no, she's a lovely girl, but she got hellish spots. But she's a nice girl. And I took her to the dance, and I said to the man, how much is it to go in? He said, it's £2 a head. Cost me £4,000 again. Anyway, I said, if I start to sing a folk song, I should be here for a week. Well, he said, sing a short one. Well, there aren't any short ones. Well, he said, rewrite one. So what I've done, I've rewritten a very famous Devonshire folk song, Tom Pierce's Grey Mare, and We'll All Go to Widdicombe Fair. Now, I would like to dedicate this song, if you could just be serious for a minute, to an old uncle of mine who unfortunately was killed in the Battle of the Little Bighorn. Well, he wasn't actually in the battle. He was camping in the next field. And he went over to see what all the noise was, and some bugger shot him. But this is Tom. You won't be bored, because I'm going to sing this completely unaccompanied. Tom Pierce's Grey Mare, and We'll All Go to Widdicombe Fair. Much shorter than the original. And if you could keep as quiet as possible, because it's tin often I get the chance to sing in the big shed. Tin too long, you won't be bored, because I've shortened it.
Tom Pierce, Tom Pierce, lend me your grey mare.
No. Good night, God bless. Good night.
Come on, Pat.
Can we welcome
yeah,
on
back, Mooney.
Island, Mr. Pat Mooney?
Get on, Mooney. Go on, son.
Go!
Thank you very much. Welcome. Lovely to see you all. Have I lost weight? I'd like to thank you all for your kind wishes during my recent bout of anorexia. I spent my whole life looking for a woman with a figure like a banana. I believe the ball will have me now go at my home city, Belfast. Is that true? I mean, I'm going to go, lovely city, Belfast. Makes Brixton look like Disney World. What a place. Charles Bronson's the Avon lady. Yeah. What a place. Some fella in Belfast, this is true, he hated his wife that much, he wrote Protestant on her back and sent her down the wrong road. And she came home that night with £50 in her pocket because he couldn't spell Protestant. You get that? It's great being in London, isn't it? I'm staying in a place down the road in Oxford Street, the Selfridge Hotel. Wonderful place. I'm paying for it through the Halifax Building Society. I found a Bible in my room. I opened the front page and it said, if you're an alcoholic, ring this number. And I dialed the number and it was an off license in Cricklewood. Lovely being here. I was working in Jersey last night. That's a funny place, that Jersey, you know. It's full of French people. I can't stand them froggies. Any French people in? Thank God for that. Oh, I can't stand them. They're so conceited, you know, just because they came fourth in the war. Yeah. They've got some funny habits, them French. You've got to watch them, you know. They like to kiss you on both cheeks. It was very embarrassing for me. I was polishing my shoes at the time. Still, I blew them on back. Anyway, me... Don't worry about that. I was at a bar there last night. There was an Italian cocktail barman. I said, give me a typical Italian cocktail. And he poured this drink, and I drank it down. I said, my God, that's strong. Oh, he says, wonderful drink, signore. His Holiness the Pope drinks that drink. I said, blimey, is that why he falls on his knees when he gets off an aeroplane? It's great being here, because I come from, as I say, Belfast, and I've got a big family over there, you know. I've got 9 brothers and 3 sisters. My mother was either a good Catholic or a sloppy Protestant. I'm not sure, but we're not allowed birth control, you see. My brother took a chance. He walked into a chemist shop in Belfast. He says, I'll have a packet of them contradictive things, please. And the girl says, there's 75p with tax. Oh, he says, never mind the tax, I'll tie them on. Big Murphy bought one and it was too long, so he cut the end off. Big family. So everybody thinks Irish people are daft, don't you? You don't have to agree so quick, you know. We have a few daft people over there, I must admit. What about that Irish rapist? He tied the woman's legs together so she couldn't run away. Eh? Or the Irish vampire who attacked Dolly Parton and bit her neck. Little woman from Dublin was having an affair with another fella. She said, you don't have to take any precautions with me, love. I can't have a baby. My husband's had a vasectomy. Paralyze me that. I went for a vasectomy last week. The doctor says, don't you think you should let sleeping dogs lie? Lovely being here at the Palladium, honest to God. I walked in tonight, I got a, it was a star on my dressing room. I thought it was a Jewish toilet. It's lovely being here. No offence meant, actually, you know. And this one, I've got one of my brothers is very funny. He's got a barber shop over in Ireland, and it's a real Irish barber shop. It's got a sign outside, haircuts while you wait. It's Irish. Well, a one-armed man came in for a shave one day. And he's very nervous shaving this one-armed guy. Threw the towel around him, lathered him up, got the razor out. He's shaking like a leaf. He cut him on the ear, cut him on the cheek, cut him under the chin, cut him on this cheek, cut him on this ear, cut him under the nose. Jeez, there's blood everywhere. And he's trying to hold a conversation like barbers do. He says, have you been in here before, sir? The fella says, no, I lost this arm in the Falklands. Must tell you a quick guy, because we haven't got very long. There was a, this, I love this, you can tell the kids this. There was an Irishman, an Englishman and a Scotsman caught by the cannibals in Africa. And the cannibal chief stripped them off to the waist. And they got hold of the English fella, felt all over the skin. He says, oh, you have beautiful skin. You make wonderful canoe. English fella says, canoe? With my skin, you must be kidding, pal. Most English people are very heroic. I'm an exception to the rule. I can't stand pain. Do me a favour, finish me off as quick as you can. So they chopped his head off. And they come to the Scots fella, felt all over his skin. He says, oh, you have incredible skin. You make magnificent canoes. Scots fella says, hey, Jimmy. I'm like my pal from England. I can't stampede another. Finish me off as quick as you can. So they chopped his head off. And they come to the big Irish fella from County Kerry. Felt all over his skin. He says, oh, you have fantastic skin. You make incredible canoe. The big Irish fella says, can I have a last request? Cannibal chief says, yes. What is your request? He says, I'd like a fork. And they give him this fork and he says, you're not making a bloody canoe out of me. Ladies and gentlemen, good night and God bless you. You're lovely. Ladies and gentlemen, it's my great pleasure to introduce to you a legend in British comedy. Would you please welcome Frankie Howard?
So here we are, then, ladies and gentlemen. The Madden Man's, by the way, this is called the Madden Man's National Anthem. It's called I Haven't Had a Bang Since Firework Night. And Married Man's National Anthem, may God be with you all. I'm married to a woman, Big Aggie is her name. From the day I said I will, I've suffered grief and pain. She talks and talks and talks and talks and talks and talks and talks. and talks and talks and talks and talks and talks and talks and eats. Then she nips into the fountain, that's the pub across the street, that's where all the scandalmongers and the heavy boozers meet. It was my wife, Mrs. Sykes, and Mrs. Hardcastle. Three wives in the fountain, each one knocking back the stout. There they sit in the fountain till it's time for chucking out. Three old bags in the fountain, each one longing for to roam. There they sit in the fountain, too far gone to stagger home. Which one is the biggest pest? Which one will the cops arrest? Their coins they are counting, hoping they can pay the fine. Just one wife will get sentenced. One will soon be doing time. Make it mine, make it mine, make it.
Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Frankie Howard and orchestra, Sonny Rogers. Frankie Howard.
What do you reckon then, Bernard? One paper's given us good coverage anyway tonight.
Oh, yeah.
How did you get roped in and involved in this one?
Well, I'm a friend of Rupert Murdoch's, you know. I used to stand outside the gates waving my fists.
Evening. Nice to see you. Very nice to see you. Wonderful show you've had tonight. We've got some surprises for you in the second half. We're going to have a fire practice and piss off. Did you watch the last series when they gambled all them nine prizes and lost the star prize? Did you see that? Greedy bastards. Served them right. Now... Don't take any prisoners tonight. Get stuck in. Now, listen. I must get some ointment for these. Now, went to see a mate of mine last week. He had terrible trouble with his heart. I said, how are you doing with your heart now? He said, I'm a lot better. He said, I've had a pacemaker fitted. I said, that's very good. He said, I think it's Japanese. I said, what makes you think that? He said, every time I fart, the garage door's open. Now, please your bloody self, we're not getting paid. I'm not bothered. I'm stopping on. I just sorted out tonight. I saw the girls at the front. It's lovely to see you all, and thanks seriously for coming. But, I mean, to see you at the Palladium, I mean, all of us, we've all said it about it. Delight to work this theatre. It's wonderful. And I've seen the girls at the front here tonight. And you've obviously made an effort, haven't you, tonight? It's a, before you came, it's a bath job, isn't it? Hey? You've had that immersion heater on a couple of hours, haven't you? Hey? You've saved up. Hey? Now, they do say an Englishman's home is his castle, but it's not. You know about this. It's your bathroom, isn't it? You've all done this. When you get in the bathroom, hey, and you bolt the door, you're in there on your own, aren't you? It's Fantasy Island, isn't it? Hey? You've all done this, haven't you? Take your dressing gown off, have a laugh. Maybe a search. And you run your bath, and the water's in the bath, it's red hot. You can boil an egg in it. No way can the human frame stand that temperature. But you've paid for that electric, so stuff them. You're not going to cool that down, are you? You've all done this, haven't you? Hand on the side of the bath. Hey, you've all done this. Up with the foot, isn't it? And you lower your foot down, and when your foot touches the water, it's this, isn't it? It's, oh. And you lower your foot down, saying things like, oh, yeah. And when your foot touches the bottom, you leave it there a minute, then you look down and it looks like you've got a maroon sock on. Now you think that's cooled the water down, so you put the other foot in then. Oh, yeah, back! It's the same temperature. Hey, and it doesn't stop the steam coming up, does it?
All the steam's coming up round the lunchbox and the old, isn't it? Eh? Good for us lads. Steam on the old. Oh, yeah, good for it. No problem for the girls. There's somewhere for it to go. But us lads. Us lads. Us lads, steam on the winkle. It's a greenhouse job. Oh, yeah. Do you know, after a good bath, I can write Lamb Dudden on mine? Honest, I can. Hey, sometimes Junction. And on a cold morning, it just says Ludo. I don't know where the letters go. Then you've done the next bit, haven't you? You shuffle forward a bit. You've all done this. Nothing wrong with this. Shuffle forward, don't you? And you lower yourself down. And you can feel that steam coming up, can't you? Eh? And it's going through your mind, you're thinking, I'm not half going to burn my arse in a minute. But the amazing thing is, now think about this. The amazing thing is you lower yourself down, and as soon as your bum touches that water, is this what happens or not? As soon as your bum touches, it's this, isn't it? It's, ack, ack, off, ack, ack. I can never understand that. You burn your bum and your lungs pack up. I can't understand that. But then you lower yourself down saying things like, ask him, ref. And what a relief when you touch the bottom, isn't it? You sit there absolutely still, don't you? You're thinking, for Christ's sake, don't make a wave. Then you lie back in the bath, don't you? You think, I'll just put some Radox in, then I can have a pee and nobody will know. You do that. Thank you very much indeed. You've been a super audience. Have a good night. God bless you. Thanks a lot. You really are super. Thanks very much indeed. Well, you've no idea how thrilled we are that you're here with us tonight. We've got a little surprise for you now. Even in the middle of June, British summertime, we're going to take you back to pantomime. And we'd like you to sit back and look at a rather different version of two characters famous in pantomime. Will you look at and listen to a talent which belongs to Cinders and Buttons?
Hello, boys and girls. My name's Buttons. Say hello, Buttons. Hello, boys and girls. Hello, mums and dads. Hello, band. See, Smudge is pissed off then. Hello, royal family. Fuck it. Oh. Very nice. Have you seen Cinderella anywhere, boys and girls? Because I'm in love with her and I want to... Oh, she's a lovely girl, Cinderella. She's the daughter of Baron Hard Up. He's a nice man, but then ugly sisters pick on him and they pick on poor Cinderella. Oh, I wish I could see her. Oh, look. Here comes Cinders now.
Buttons, Buttons.
You've lost weight, Cinders. Cinders. Oh, there she is, two of my favourites. Cinders, what's the matter?
Oh, Buttons, it's the Prince's ball.
Christ.
Oh, no, Buttons, I'm worried about the Prince's ball.
Well, what's up with it?
Oh, it's off.
Well, don't worry, Cinders, I suppose he's holding another one.
I hope so. Daddy says they're the biggest balls in the land.
Hello, Smudge. Nice of you to pop in, mate. But hey, dude. Biggest balls in the land. The biggest balls in the land. Where's the script? Script. Biggest balls in the land. Balls, tits, shit, sod, tits, balls. Balls. Bun, shit, but never mind, never mind, never mind, Cinders. I suppose you'll be invited. I mean, I've been invited. I'm going to the ball.
You can't.
I'm a what? It's nice, isn't it? It's got about as much chance as Bernard Manning of getting on that.
No, Buttons. You can't go to the ball. You need a ticket.
But, Cinders, didn't I see Dan Deeney giving you one in the woods?
Yes, Buttons, but then I told my ugly sisters and look what they did to the ticket.
Bastards. You're wasting your time here, pal. We might as well piss off now. This ain't going to be on the telly. Can you lip read? You laughed then, didn't you? You don't want this ticket, no. You don't want to go to that ball anyway. It's full of all them posh people who get out of the bath and have a wee in the sink, innit? Not like us pissing a sponge and squeeze it in the sink, isn't it? About time I'd done a bit, isn't it? Come on, Cinders, I'll tell you a secret. Sit up here. Sit up here.
Do some cooking?
Oh, we're going to do the cooking then, aren't we? We're not sitting up here. Why are we living in a lake? Time's up. The cooking.
Yeah, come on.
I suppose a cook's out the question.
What are we going to make, then?
Buttons get sausages. It'd be sausages, then, wouldn't it? Sausage and egg pie.
All right, well, you get the sausages.
Here they are, look.
Put the sausages in the pie.
Put the sausages in the pie.
Yeah.
Cinders, the sausages are behaving a bit strange, aren't they?
Yeah.
Boys and girls, if... What's that little bit on the end of the sausage? It must have got a pamphlet through the door. That little bit's what you put your foot on when you pull them off, see? Oh, behold! Let's catch it after three. One, two, three. Boys and girls, if you see another sausage, you will let us know, won't you? Cinders, a black pudding!
Pudding!
Who was that? He was wearing my Rolex. Ain't got free cars from Bristol and all, have you, mate? Yeah, they're going to close Bristol and turn it into a slum, sir.
Next, we need some eggs.
Be an improvement. Oh, eggs.
Yeah.
Ooh, I like eggs. I know a lot about eggs, me, Cinders.
Yeah?
In fact, do you know why some hens lay brown eggs and some hens lay white?
No.
Some hens don't bother to wipe their...
Buttons.
Oh, stop. Timing. Hey, do you know what? If you get an egg and squash it like that... You can't break them, you know that. You try it, kids, when you get in. If you're watching this on the television in Holland, if you have got an eggy from the chicken bird... You're getting this earth going to front room and you give me bigger squeezing bear to flirt. You bastard. Oh, well, we'll do that joke later on then.
Hello, me son. Read in the paper about you, grand for the box flash bastard, have that.
So, Redland.
Oh, Cinders, look, there's bits of your ticket all over the floor. Well, you won't be needed anymore.
Buttons. I really wanted to go to the ball.
Oh, no. Oh, Cinders, don't. Well, you don't want to go to that ball. Shall I tell you that secret I was going to tell you early on before the cooking bit?
Go on, then.
All right, sit up here, then. Let me lift you up. The electronics are hanging out.
We've ever heard that before.
A Piff Gold Mark IV, please.
The leg's gone. Leg's gone. You're too heavy, Cinders. Very good. What happened there, then?
My microphone came on.
You don't want to do that. Betty, I got a bit of soap stuck up my bum.
That's life, boy.
Cinders, can I tell you my secret?
Go on, then.
Well, it's only a little one.
Never mind buttons.
No, my secret is a little what? I'm in love.
Oh, buttons, that's great. Oh, what's she like?
Hey?
This girl you're in love with, what's she like?
I thought you knew. Well, she's got nice blonde hair and blue eyes, and she's got a really nice dress, and she's got blue nails and about 5 grand's worth of Tom on the fingers, but... And she really is the most beautiful girl in the whole of the world.
I can't think who that is.
It's you, Cinders.
Oh, buttons. Do you want to know something too?
What?
I'm in love.
Oh. Are ya?
Yeah.
I knew you were. Yeah. Hey, this bloke you're in love with, what's he look like then?
Oh, well, he's handsome.
Yeah.
He's very strong. Oh, he's ever so charming. Do you know who it is, Buttons?
Yeah.
Who?
It's me.
Oh, Buttons, no, it's not you. I'm in love with Prince Charming.
Oh, shit. Hear that, John? Have you ever heard anything like it? Prince Charming.
Oh, Buttons, you didn't
It's a woman think... dressed up. It's got lumps.
You didn't think I was in love with you, did you?
Yeah, of course I did. Oh, Cinders. Cinders, I can't understand it. I try and be so nice to you. And then I just want to be with you on my own and... Every time I get you on my own, that bastard in the flat upstairs starts playing that poxy oboe. I'm upset. What colour are you? Thanks.
All right.
I'm not Cinders, I just don't know what to do now. I'll clear up. See, I can't even be serious now, can I? Just when I want to tell you things. I want to explain why we're living in a river. John Avery, the manager, said it was a kitchen scene, the book. He got pissed down at Drury Lane and brought the wrong thing up. See, that they're all in the wings, they don't care, they have a laugh. Old Buttons, he'll make us laugh, he'll say silly things. You don't really care that I mean it, Cinders, I love you. I do. Do you know, I only work here because of you. I don't get paid and them ugly sisters pick on me as well.
I like to have gone out. Look at that. I'm wearing Ronnie Corbett's suit. Ain't funny, he's still in it. I just thought that one day you could take me seriously and I'd get a job, I'd work, I really wouldn't. And I could build a little house and you don't have to like me straight away, I promise I'll be good and I just want to make you happy, Cinderella. I want to marry you and I want to take you away from all this and I know it's just a stupid dream, but if you was my girlfriend, I'd be the happiest man in the world and I'd live for happily ever after.
Oh, but you really do love me, don't you?
Do you know, Cinders, if I owned the world, I'd give it all to you, I really would.
Then can I have a bite of your apple?
Fuck off.
Some crap on here tonight, have you? I bet you're fucking glad he's gone off the other fella, have you? Hey, him with the guitar. Quick impression, Frank Bruno. Been on the canvas that many times, he's got a cauliflower arse. There's nothing nicer though, Saturday afternoon, bike pot of tea, a nice plate pot of sandwiches, and watch two niggers knocking fuck out of one another. Hey? Priorities are all wrong in this country, aren't they? We've got kids getting battered and murdered and old people getting raped and mugged. And all the Duke of Edinburgh is worried about, there's only 1,000 pandas left in the world. I mean, who gives a fuck about pandas? It won't worry me if I've never seen a fucking panda. Even a panda won't fuck a panda. That's why there's no fucking pandas. It's easy enough to work out, isn't it? Can't stop us laughing, can they? Hey, it's the only thing we got left, a good laugh. This time last year, we'd had the miners' strike. Arthur Scargill, he went for a circumcision operation. The surgeon said, I can't operate on this man. He said, there's no end to this prick. He'll never suffer with piles. God made him a perfect arsehole, that fella. How can you call a coal strike on the hottest fucking summer for 100 years? Eh? That's why the Labour Party will never get back in. They're promising people work. Who the fucking hell wants to go to work? Stood waiting for a bus in the pissing rain, 7:30 in the morning, few sandwiches under your arm. Work your bollocks off all day. Come home at 7 o'clock at night in the pissing rain again. Coming up the street, ringing wet through, and all the fucking packies waving at you through the window. Yeah. This is a pressure job. Comics are dropping like flies. Every time you open the paper, there's one gone. Thank fuck it's all the thin uns. Leonard Rossiter played squash every day, jogger every day, 47 years of age. Fucked, dead and buried. I've got a fucking celebrant of that Cinzano Bianco shit at my club. Not sold a bottle since he died, the lousy bastard. Ted Moat shot himself, nobody heard it, the fucking windows are shut. One month, Arthur Askey, Tommy Cooper, Eric Morgan. A fella rang me up and said, how do you feel? I've got you on a Yankee. Englishman, Irishman and Scotchman walking along the beach. There's a mermaid there. And the English fellow went up and said, have you ever been kissed? She said, no, so he kissed her. And the Scotchman said, have you ever been fondled? She says, no, so he fondled her. And the Irish fellow said, have you ever been fucked? She says, no. He says, well, yeah, now the fucking tide's just gone out. He says. They won't let you tell these gags on the television, you see. You've got to come out for a good laugh, haven't you? Why does a chicken cross the road? Who gives a fuck why a chicken crosses the road? Why did the pervert cross the road now? He couldn't get his prick out of the chicken. I'd love to tell that on Stars on Sunday. Wouldn't have live that bloody programme up, wouldn't it? You know what my ambition is? To go live on the Antique Roadshow and say to some old woman, you know what that's worth? Fuck all. Well, my last time here. Little old Jewish fella on his deathbed, he says, are you there, Becky? She says, I'm here, Imee. He says, when I came home from the war in 1918, you were by my side. I went in the concentration camp in 1933, you were by my side. I opened that little shop just after the war, I went bankrupt. I didn't have 2 shillings to call my own. You were by my side. I'm dying now and you're still by my side. Becky, he says, you're a fucking jinx. There's a cat getting ready to go out, sprucing its fur up, doing its whiskers. Little kitten at the side says, where are you going, Dad? He said, I'm going fucking some. He says, can I come with you, Dad? He says, certainly, you've got to learn sometime, son, come on. Get behind this chip shop. He said, you sit on that wall, I'll sit here. Meow, meow. Oh, 6 buckets of water. Fucking salt pots, vinegar pots. Sat there, piss wet through with a pair of them. Come on, he said, we go behind the snooker hall. You sit on that wall, I'll sit here. Meow, meow. Another 6 buckets of water. Fucking billiard balls, snooker cues. Come on, he said, we'll go behind the railway yard. The kitten said, listen, Dad, one more fucking, let's go home. The Welsh Guards were surrounded by 10 million Zulus. You must have seen that film. Brave men, them Welsh Guards, you know, all over 6'1" and nasty bastards and all. Took no shit for nobody, them lads, you know. Fucking spears coming from all over the show. Millions of spears. Blow pipes. The bastards, them niggas, don't play fair, them bastards, you know. Our lads only had guns. Front rank, fire, reload. Reload, fire. Reload, fire. Di Davies right in the middle. We'll keep a welcome in the hill. 200 of his mates went down, his body's all over the place. This land of song will still be. Another 300, the sergeant said, for fuck's sake, Di, sing them something they fucking know. Oh, dear. Irish fella put a friend's letter on backwards and went. There's a shepherd having a driving test. The instructor says, can you make a U-turn? He says, make a U-turn, I'll make his fucking eyes water. Irish fella went for a job on a building site. He says, what's your name? He says, Paddy Mulligan. He says, how do you spell it? He says, stick the job up your arse. What about the Irish fellow went to a Ku Klux Klan fancy dress ball as Al Jolson? Unbelievable. Anyway, we haven't got to do long tonight. I'd like to do longer, but everybody's waiting to get home back there. Jim, I won't hog the stage, son. We've seen some shit tonight, son. It's a good job I've gone on last. But, What's on now, Jim? Is something else in on? Stripper does a split over a Guinness bottle here tonight. And it never cost a fucking fortune this afternoon. It was 14 crates of Guinness this afternoon. Anyway, thanks for turning up. That's the main thing. I know my stuff doesn't suit everybody. And if it, you know, if it's offended anybody out there, it's your own fucking business for coming. Look after yourselves, and I'll see you again sometime, maybe. Good night.
the incomparable Mr. Bernard Manning. Ladies and gentlemen. Bernard, you're the governor. Give him a round of applause, ladies and gentlemen.
Hello, everybody out there.
People say, you know, why are you doing this show? You know, you don't do it as a little bit of recognition. We raised a few quid. Honestly, we don't really care about that. It's just to show that we care. You show your care by staying this bloody late and listening to all our boring old jokes. And we've really tried to say what we feel. And with all of us, I think we've done a good job. Thank you very much for coming along. We'll leave you with a little finale now. Another thing the Sun did a while ago. There's a little song you might like to join in. Thank you very much for coming along. God bless you. All the best.
In times of trouble, Mother Mary comes to me, speaking words of wisdom, let it be.
But in my hour of darkness, she is standing right in front of me, speaking words of wisdom, let it be.
Let it be.
Let it be.
Let it be,
let it be.
Speaking words of wisdom, let it be.
There's still a chance that they might see. There will be an answer, let it be.
'Cause though they may be parted, there is still a chance that they might see. There will be an answer, let it be.
Let it be.
Let it be.
Let it be.
Let it be. There will be an answer, let it be.
Let it be.
Let it be.
Let it be.
Let it be. Whisper words of wisdom, let it be. There is still a chance that they might see. There will be an answer, let it be.
Wake up in the darkness, Mother Mary comes to me.
Ooh, yeah.
Speaking words of wisdom,
let it be.
Can you stand up?
Oh, let it be.
Come on, stand up.
Let it be.
Gold, ladies and gentlemen. What a wonderful crew. What a mob. Come on, give a cheer. Thank you very much for everything you've done. God bless you. See you soon. Bye-bye.
A Wiener World presentation.